Good evening. Thank you for joining us tonight. Let us start with prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the facilities we have here, for the opportunity to come together and celebrate the hard work that our students and our teachers have put in this quarter. Thank you for the hard work that we can observe out in the lobby. Thank you for the music that we will hear tonight. Just thank you so much for the gift of music and art, this way to express beauty, a way to worship you, and just celebrate your creativity. Ask that you be with the students tonight to relax, to be able to enjoy this experience, to celebrate the hard work that they put in this quarter. And Lord, thank you once again for this facility that brought us together tonight as a community. In your name I pray. Amen.
Start with the first movement of Mozart's Divertimento in D major, K136, written in Salzburg in winter 1772. This allegro has a lovely theme that ends with a fun little surprise. The middle section shifts to a minor key and features violins over lively violas and clock bass, instead of just repeating the main theme. Thank you and enjoy the performance.
Thank you.
We'll be performing Vivaldi's Concerto for Four Violins in B minor for Alessandro Armonico, published in 1711. This piece features multiple solo violins contrasted with a string orchestra, emphasizing interplay over pure virtuosity. This piece features multiple solo violins contrasted with a string orchestra, emphasizing interplay over pure virtuosity. It's the most famous of Vivaldi's concertos for four violins, showcasing rapid exchanges and rhythmic variety among these soloists. The opening allegro quickly developed its theme. This slow movement has a dramatic introduction, and the final movement features a powerful ritornello with dynamic combinations of the solos. Please hold your applause until the end of the performance, when the entire orchestra stands. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. legend Chuck Berry, written and performed by him in 1958 and released as a single the same year. The song gained renewed fame when it was featured in the film Back to the Future in 1985, showcasing Michael J. Fox as Marty McFly, performing it at a high school dance. A standout aspect of Berry's original recording is the striking contrast between the swinging drums and the straight rhythmic lead guitar. In our session, we embraced the spirit of classic rock and roll, dividing into melodic and pentatonic scales, as well as techniques like pull-offs and note bending. We dedicate this to all the parents, titas, titos, and grandparents. Enjoy!
Thank you. these last two songs to clap. One thing that a lot of people don't know that you guys are learning tonight is that silence is a part of music. And so sometimes the silence is really important to set up for the next thing that the composer wanted to do. So this next piece, there's going to be a part where it gets quiet for a minute and you're going to want to clap, but don't.
Thank you.
programs, you don't miss any of the performances that are coming up next quarter. Can you pray with me as we finish tonight? Father God, you are worthy to be praised. You deserve all the praise, all the glory, all the honor we can give. Wherever there is music, may it be sweet to your ears. And wherever our feet take us, leaving this place, may our lives be sweet to you as well. In Jesus' name, we deserve all our praise, all the glory. Amen.